I'm back at it, man, and I had to free up some space, and not sure, well, yeah, I had to free up some space, because I ended up putting part one in my little hard drive, external hard drive, that is, so then I can make up some space. But what I was saying earlier, oh yeah, basically just, you know, J. Cole just showcasing that, you know, he still, may still got a lot to learn, despite of all he's done. You know what I mean? Like, that's just the whole gist of the last, especially on the last few bars, but this entire, like, stanza, not stanza, but this entire, all these bars right here, though, basically just showcasing that, you know what I mean? And sometimes that's how you feel, like, in the pursuit of trying to make things better for you and your children, you may have felt you probably crossed, may have, like, not necessarily, more so betrayed same people that look at you as an icon, hero, and or even a superhero at that, like Superman, equivalent to Superman or some shit, because of all the money you accumulated, the millions, and this all came from him running to some guy at the store, like, yesterday, like, whatever that day it may have been, you know what I mean? And just after hearing that compliment from old dude giving him all these props, like, say, hey, appreciate what you're doing, that's real, which this is very, hold on, let me say, hold on, what am I about to say? Anyway, this very fitting, though, very fitting, because J. Cole has done a lot, and, you know, he's definitely a real one, in my eyes, I mean, regardless, let it go. Okay, what's going on? Big is nice though. I can't hang on it. That's real shit right there, man. And, like, and all, of course, we often sob, cry, self-explanatory, the black community, and as far as painful memories, just all the stuff that comes with being black in America, you know what I mean? Just constantly seeing your people just dying, you know what I mean? From the hands of just crooked police officers and the system that's set up by racism, fear is the foundation of it being racism at that, like, bass of slavery, all that. I mean, colonization, also, of course, pillaging from Native Americans. So, yeah. It really throws off the vibe, especially these times, man. Especially recently with the shooting of George Floyd, Breonna Taylor, and whole too many people to name that have been unlawfully killed by police officers. And just the whole system just not doing its part as far as punishing its said officers. And continuing not to look at this, like, human beings, as we should be looked as, like, multifaceted human beings, and not just either one way or another, you know what I mean? That's pretty much all we ask for at the end of the day. And as far as, like, though I be trying to let the time in my mind, bruh, so fitting to the times we're in. And whoever's singing this is on point. And we may have gotten older, and, well, basically what he's saying in this song right here, like, how he may have gotten older, but he's still a boy in God's eye, because, you know, referencing to how God, how we created from God, and we are God's children. So even though, like, Christians, many people of the Christian religion may be adults physically, in the faith, spiritual growth, they may still be viewed as children in the eyes of God. You know what I mean? And these last few lines pretty much drive the point home.
Fill me up with wisdom, some courage, plus endurance to survive.
Basically, in the practice of essentially, like the whole practice of prayer and like how most people ask God for like wisdom and such, like it just helped them like get through it. You know what I mean? That's pretty much what the last few lines just basically said. And definitely his own. Oh man, I wish this song was a lot longer, but I'm sure he probably got something else. He might have another version on the way, maybe, if like his label or Cole himself doesn't like try to backtrack or, you know, write some half-ass apology to the sensitive motherfuckers out there that took the song way out of context and not even bother. This is the old boys, like his, let me rephrase that. Old boys verse after J. Cole's verse, you know what I mean? Because the verse he sung is very relevant, man, how we all feeling, like, how we all feeling at the moment, in this point in time. Like, I'm not going to sit here and repeat myself. You already know, man, you already know. But, like, if you like the song and you're a fan of J. Cole or Dreamville, be sure to subscribe and comment. I might do more if you want me to react, if y'all send me the requests in the comments section below. And I'm definitely going to keep these reaction videos coming and might do another video where I exclusively discuss all the things that's going on in the country, which I've already explained, not already explained, but I explained parts of it throughout this long video. I'm sure it's going to be long as fuck. I even said on Facebook it might be close to 40 minutes long. So, but anyway, like the song itself, though, it's dope. It's amazing. Don't know what these people are talking about because they're fucking idiots, and that's the only thing it is. Like, matter of fact, I might do, like, matter of fact, fuck it. I'm gonna say something like this. Like, now the lines where it got everyone in their feelings, like the ones I've broken down, the bars and such, I got everyone in their feelings, how he basically is giving props and such. I can somewhat understand, like, why some of the women in those outrage crowd maybe in their feelings because they may have been through experiences that were abusive and heard it from in that context and the tone. Like, because that's what the key thing is. Like, the tone that it may have heard it from said abusive partner was probably used to demean them and gaslight what they're feeling. You feel me? Or from, like, racist motherfuckers out there. Like, that's probably the tone that they heard it from. So they thinking when they heard the song, the lyrics, they just blew out of proportion and thought it was spoken in that those tones. But clearly on here, it was not the case. So yeah, it was kind of a jump in the reach to even say like Cole is even disrespectful to women, like for real. Because if you look at his catalog, he praises women, like praises black women, because he has songs like She Knows, Runaway, Crooked Smile, and also Lost Ones, where he raps from the perspective of a single mother talking to her baby daddy. So check that song out if y'all forgot or simply do not know. Also, Phone and Clothes. He talking about Phone Clothes for, well, yeah, talking about Phone Clothes for his woman. Like, basically, it's an anthem for all the dudes that's married that's Phone Clothes for their women. So, like, he's always praise black women. He always had y'all back. So for black women get tripping, which I can understand based on what I just said, is like just not called for, man. It just y'all just took it out of context. Simple as that. And didn't even try to pay attention to how we sang in the verse instead of just relying on your experiences, like I mentioned, of just fucked up situations where they use those same lines to you. So anyway, man. I'm done. I pretty much said what I had to say about it and the controversy and whatnot. But I gotta say one more thing. We need to be united as like black men and women, man. We can't just be engaged in another gender war. I fucking hate that shit. We fucking need to stand unified regardless of what we agree or disagree with, because we got the world is looking at us right now, man. We got unifying this motherfucker. For real. But I ain't gonna spend too much longer talking. I'm about to go ahead and sign off. This is Black G92. Holla at your boy. Peace.